어다 소소로 다 되니까 다니 다 물려 보대 어느 소소로 빨리 와 이사 다 될었더니 그게 맞아야 돼 기워가 니 신도가래 센 좋아도네 세메데 가 가리숄은 로가 데카제 다다 빠게 뉴뉴지도 아니 야다여 여보신 데 시작이 있어.
So, first of all, in terms of this temporary condition that we have now of this human rebirth, Geshe-la would like to share a little bit about how to use this human rebirth in the correct way to make it go in the correct direction so that one can be happy.
어당이 체도 다치게 된다 만 되지 제 비가로 쪼쪼 그게 체 도주나 거 되지 제 자는 거래스 이나요 델다네 나로 솜마세 니게 되시 간데스 저그 마세 델로 솜노 돈보르 마 돈보 간데스 또그 대우드는 세다다 레지와르 니오 가제다 데데스 되시 자 디세슈나
So then Geshe-la, he will explain from the perspective of a little bit of a high level with today's explanation. However, within this high level, we can also understand that there are many things that are very applicable to beginners, to starting just from this life, how to be happier.
o ta tri de je ja te ne so je ni ba se ge su mi are no ji ne so yang ge bo lu de se wa che te ne ji te ne shi wa ro wa so ta kong ge ji che ma ge no lo la o ta nga ro so to ja yo a shu un s mi ro wa to ja yo a shu te ne ro a she ba la sen de ni ni ji ge ge ta sna su mi wa re te ri ge de ji ja yin ji me ji ta te me na pa jin ro mo to ba ro ji re
So then, in terms of what Geshe-la will be sharing today, it comes from a great master known as the Second Buddha, called Arya Nagarjuna, and it is from a text which is known as the Precious Garland, and it talks about if one wishes to reach the ultimate object of attainment, the three things that one needs to cultivate in this life, and that if one is not able to cultivate these three things, one will definitely not be able to get to that destination.
왔다 털려 여주 세링 아로서 단다 자 침보트 대 소소솔 제와요 소소솔 포게다 영어 좀 봐도 다니지 요세 요와스 왔다 드릭 자 침보트 대야 나데 타마 타마다 코를 내가 찬로야 돼 가발레 그래서는 도저 다들 아니 손제세 아들 레소나 드니 지엘로 바셔야 마도 소소 가디나 기고진에 대해 더 있는 스킬스
So then, just to kind of set the scene for this Geshe-la thing that we often speak about having compassion for ourselves, we often talk about the importance of a self-love. But if we really think about this, then if that is something that is really honest, then this final object of attainment, this achievement of Buddhahood, this is really the best way to fulfill that. Why? Because after the achievement of enlightenment or complete Buddhahood, not only has one definitely achieved one's own welfare or aims, but one also becomes very able to bring benefit to others.
o ta tri chu chu lo ga chi de she ga ti ge zo den lo ya ten ji zo da wo so de shi ya ge ya res
So then, in terms of the shloka or verse, it's actually 1.5 verses that Geshe-la is sharing today. It is primarily explaining the three main causes of that attainment, right? Of complete Buddhahood.
ta chi de ka wa ne re sa na ten ge mo lo de ge chi cha wa no lo la yo res ani sha to la mo zong ga pa da la ma ka ge ko ji pe che to de ya chi res
So the source of this, as we mentioned it, is from the great Arya Nagarjuna, a great master, specifically from a text called the Rinchen Chenghwa, the Precious Garland. But it is also a text which is mentioned in many other works by other great masters, such as Lama Tsongkhapa, for example.
o ta chi de ma ne pa de chi jan men de chi te ba yin na tan jo ro ste ma lo ne so no to na ane pa cha man ra wa chi de ne shi lo ma no wa chi cha to ma yo re
So Geshe-la will share the words, but also if you go back to these words and read them again later and reflect on them, not only is that something that is beneficial and will bring a great understanding, but it will also help to put a very positive imprint within the mind.
오다 대응을 지청하네. 와, 너니 돈은 이땐디. 라메 쇼주 톤데나. 데이 자와 쇼주세. 로자보 따데동. 슈타 뚜비 니지에동. 니라 마테 이시라스.
So, I will read the verse that Geshe-la just shared. So, whether oneself or others of this world, if they wish to attain unsurpassed enlightenment, Its roots are bodhicitta, firm like the king of mountains. Then compassion, reaching all directions, and wisdom, not relying on duality.
O daniel to nun jiten di esere daniel sere sozoche jite sere ta sem majie senje je sa do sei na yo la me sho chu ton de na to ja ya sho na na me bi ane sunji ko kombo de ane ton de ba inas ganas.
So these lines are saying oneself and others of this world. So first of all, we ourselves that we're talking about, and then other beings, indeed all beings, any of those who wish. And it is wishing for this best object of attainment, the final object attainment, which is unsurpassed enlightenment, which means complete Buddhahood.
Oh,
if
that...
one wants that, sorry.
Oh, tell say yashu kar kar gugare sana. Oh, ti sa wa shonju se roho jabo ta te tong sir peya pedu chi peya pechi do ane te ni te ni jabo res.
So then, if one wishes to achieve that unsurpassed enlightenment, what is the best mind that one can bring forth to help one achieve that? Then the next part of the text is talking about the roots of bodhicitta, firm like the king of mountains. So this is an example, right? This supreme mind of bodhicitta, which is like a mountain. So we often speak about, for example, the five paths of the Mahayana, as well as the various grounds, bhumis, and so forth. So we could say that really, all of these seeds that we plant, the very root of this is the bodhicitta aspiration. So we want this mind of bodhicitta when it is brought forth to be stable, like Mount Meru. Geshe said whether you hold Mount Meru or not, any sort of stable mountain, we want it to be like that, something that is unchanging and unstable, right? Something that with the arising of the afflictions cannot be shaken, right? So it's a firm type of mind. And so also, maybe we can bring this bodhicitta in our mind a little bit, but whether it is firm like that or not, right? That is a question only we can know, right? It really depends upon our own efforts, our own practice, whether we achieve this stability.
And
so then the text goes on to explain, well, what is the cause of that? The cause of that bodhicitta. Well, then we speak of compassion, right? Compassion reaching all directions. So that means a compassion that is not partisan, right? Like I have compassion for this one who I like, but I won't have compassion for this one who I don't like. No, it is a compassion that reaches all directions, a compassion that encompasses all beings.
And
so then love and Geshe said compassion, but also love, because love and compassion come together, then these are like the foundations which bring forth these roots of bodhicitta. So that's what we can understand here. So we have the, just to recap, we have the first one of bodhicitta. The second point is this compassion reaching all directions. And the third, the verse says, the wisdom not relying on duality. So Geshe said, just to make it simple, we can understand this as the wisdom realizing emptiness.
Oh, o ta te sa menan to kawa kawa to sa te ni yo mare yin yin te sa ti ko tsawa yo ba kan so kumare.
So in terms of this final object of attainment, right, which is the unsurpassed enlightenment, Buddhahood, these are the three, we could say almost like the three main causes. So these are three things that we definitely need to bring forth. If we are not able to bring forth feeling and experience of these, then how would we be able to achieve enlightenment, right? It won't happen. So this is the one perspective, right, that if we are aiming for this supreme realization of complete enlightenment, we won't be able to do it without these three causes or these three factors. However, even if you just think about the perspective of this life alone, if you bring in bodhicitta, compassion, and an understanding of emptiness, you greatly enhance your quality of life. This life almost becomes like playing, like a game, right? Much greater happiness. So then, just in terms of these first points, then perhaps bodhicitta, this has a bit of a specific connotation. If one hasn't studied, maybe one doesn't know, but definitely with love and compassion, these are things that everybody can touch, can experience. And we see that even just on the temporary level, on those moments where we have more love and compassion in our mind, right, there is much greater happiness. We see how they contribute to that happiness. And so that's why Lama Tsongkhapa gives the instruction that appears in many of his texts, including the Lamrim Chemo, the great treatise on the stages of the path of enlightenment, that through thinking about the welfare of others, one's own welfare is very naturally achieved. So then if we think about the bodhisattvas, we understand that because they have developed these minds, then whatever animal appears before them, right, because whatever being appears before them, whether human or animal, because of their development of love and compassion, because they view it within this frame of love and compassion, whatever is before them, their mind is always able to abide in a quality of happiness. So really, in terms of ourselves too, we should understand this, that if we can cultivate this mind and sort of get rid of our false thinking, get rid of our judgments, our projections, and any human being or animal that we encounter have a feeling that this person is very close to me, this person or this being is precious to me, and on this basis develop love and compassion, then definitely our mind will become happier. And so if we can think in this way, right, and we can activate our mind, once that activation happens with these principles, then definitely we will be able to see a real change. So from day to day, from month to month, from year to year, then really just see those beings who you are gathering as being close to you. You know, don't push them away. Don't see them as far away.
This one? No.
But inter jump at
Nije. Also Madani Jitemba de Matoa, the Somba Zumba Temba de Matoa, Pajeshiki, Sem Momo Yarwas.
So then in terms of these principles of love and compassion, right, and the attitude of kindness that we want to develop, we understand that also there are many factors which hinder them, right? There are many obstacles, minds like attachment, anger, aversion, jealousy, and so forth. So these will hinder the development of those. So emptiness, the last part of wisdom not relying on reality, emptiness, this is important because these mistaken minds, right, which are hindering the love and compassion, these arise due to a mistaken apprehension of the object or of the other person, for example.
Oh, you know what you call us on the other side. That's not a certain thing. No, 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 no.
And because the apprehension behind that appearance is wrong, we grasp at that appearance mistakenly. So this leads to many false appearances, which lead to problems. So what happens with us is we have this ignorance grasping at the self, which is kind of like the root giving rise to its, in a way, servant minds of attachment, anger, and so forth. And they are grasping at this appearance, thinking that it is real, not realizing that this is a false appearance. Because we never question it, then we follow this false appearance. And then by following this false appearance with our conduct and so forth, we run into all sorts of problems and negative consequences.
Oh, that needs the digi, yeah, is that Tumbani is that the Pasho Yete, Chapa Shesaga, your Kundu Shesaga, Yala Soba, and I said, you are married, Dennis, you are married.
So, also, when we talk about emptiness, it's very important to mention this, that when we talk about the appearance of the object, so for example, the other person, and we talk about attachment and anger and so forth arising, the emptiness is not saying that that being or that person, right, the basis of that appearance is not there at all, but what it is telling us is that it does not really exist in the way that it appears through the lens of our anger, through the lens of our attachment, and so forth. It's not really existing in the way that it appears in those situations. So actually, if we just check, we can really see that through this lens of anger, the appearance of that object, that's not so much in accord with reality. Through the lens of attachment, the appearance of that object, that is not in accordance with reality. But just knowing this, right, it's not like we're going to be able to instantly kind of like have a radical decrease in that attachment or aversion.
Oh, that the rich is a man to come up with it, come jack with it, he's so ghost at the catch him or is that it? Oh, that is the rich you are.
So that's why it's important that we need to meditate on these principles. We need to hear the teachings, contemplate them, meditate them, and through hearing, contemplation, and meditation, we will habituate ourselves to this understanding, and we will be able to understand how the way the thing really is and how it appears is not the same. So then with a happy mind and also having conviction that there is some truth in these teachings, then as much as possible, please bring forth the minds of love, compassion that arise bodhicitta, as well as cultivate an understanding of emptiness. And then not only will we be happier, but those around you will be happier, and we will be able to have better lives.
Yeah, teacher.
All right, thank you. We'll end here.